Meanwhile, Vedanta remains in a sweet spot, says Chairman Navin Agarwal. On the sidelines of ET Awards, shares plans to invest $8 to $10 billion in the next few years.
More broadly speaking about the economy in general, it's like a seesaw. Suddenly you see people talking about micro looking good but macro not looking good, and then suddenly in the last few weeks the whole air is changing, where the general perception is that even the macro is looking good in favor of the nation. And as far as Vedanta is concerned, as you know, we continue to see ourselves in a sweet spot. This year looks like one of our best years ever, and we have an investment plan to invest the next $8-10 billion in the next 2-3 years, mainly in hydrocarbons, in oil and gas, and we are looking forward to that investment. On the commodity cycle itself, oil prices will range anywhere between $60 to $85, and other than that, for us, we focus more on our cost of production. But at the same time, I also want to add to you that other than the fact what is happening to our volumes, what's happening to our cost, what's happening to our balance sheet, what is fundamental to Vedanta is our pillars, and those pillars are actually around aspects of sustainability, aspects of leveraging technology, digital innovation, our people practices. And we think that as we get those pillars right, I think the cycles will come and go, but as long as our pillars are in place, we are in good shape.
So I agree, you've already always maintained that at Cain, it's about the cost of production. You kept it so low that irrespective of what global oil prices are, you will actually be in the green. What kind of volume numbers are you broadly eyeing at or targeting over 3-4-5 year period?
So on the oil, this is in public domain. We have said that you are aware that we have recently won some 41 new blocks. And we believe that from our existing fields, as we invest in the fields, we think we have an opportunity on a broader scale to get to 500,000 barrels of production a day from currently about 200-225,000 barrels a day. So 500,000 barrels a day is what we are looking for in the next 3-4 years time.
So what about aluminum, copper, that side of the business? How are realizations and what's the outlook on realization?
When you say realizations for mining and metal products, it's with the LME. So LMEs at this point of time are about $2,000 for aluminum, about $2,600 for zinc. And these are decent prices. So contrary to common perception, we don't really like too many very high prices. These are stable prices. I think from here, we see some upside in aluminum price going forward.
So last question, you are looking at a lot of distressed asset as well as a group here in India, and you've got very stiff competition as well, both locally and globally, people are wanting those assets. What's the game plan? Would you like to go about in a measured manner? You are quite aggressive, you think these assets can be turned around and can be scaled up. What's the broad game plan here?
So no, I don't think we want to be aggressive. The good thing for us is that our balance sheet is in very good shape. Our debt equity is less than 1, and net debt to EBITDA is less than 1. And so we are going to protect our balance sheet. At this point of time, you are aware, we acquired Electro Steel. We are looking to grow Electro Steel from its current level of 1.5 million tons to 3 million tons. And as far as other assets are concerned, we think that opportunities will come, and we want to be selective. At the same time, we will look at assets which we think have value.
Okay, that was Navin Agarwal from Vedanta, but let's shift back to the hot topic that has been the RBI board meet, and who better than Mr.